Hello, everyone. In this video, we will see together how to internationalize a Next.js application, and in this case, a Next.js 15 application. For this, we will use IntLayer. IntLayer is an internationalization, and more broadly, a content management solution for your JavaScript application. What I suggest is to start directly by creating a new Next.js application. I leave TypeScript, ESLint, everything as default. Great. Now the first thing to do will be to install the packages related to IntLayer. We will need IntLayer for the declaration of our content, you'll see, and NextIntLayer to integrate everything into our components. Once it's ready, I'm just going to open this up in VS Code. The first thing to do is create an intlayer.config.ts file to declare the different languages of our application. Then I go to my next.config.ts file and add the with IntLayer plugin. Now in my sr/app directory, I'm going to add a directory called local, like this. Inside it, I'll add a page.tsx and a layout.tsx. For the root layout, I remove everything and simply return the children like this. I go back to my local layout and add the HTML and body content that we deleted from the root layout. Next, to allow IntLayer to statically render each of my pages, I'll export generate static params from NextIntLayer. We will now tackle the page of our application. Here, we have two providers to insert, one for server components and another for client components. These two providers are separated because it is recommended to import the client provider into the layout of our application in order to share this context between the different pages. In comparison, the server provider cannot be placed in the layout because it relies on a mechanism based on the React cache. If we placed it in the layout, the context would be lost, and our server components would no longer be translated. Now, let's try to launch our application and display this page, which will simply render the language selected by the user. To do this, we run the application with the npm run dev command. We get a little message from IntLayer telling us that it has compiled our dictionaries, but currently we don't have any. We'll see how to create one a little later. I launch the application, and I get an error here, which is normal since the page at the root no longer exists. Now I can load the pages in English, French, or Spanish. That's great, but I'd like to find my default language at the root of my application, so English. To do this, I go to the SRC directory, add a middleware.ts file, and export the middleware from IntLayer. Now if I go back to my application, at the root of the website, I am in English. Then in the SRC directory, I create a new components directory and add a component called MyComponent. I declare a very simple component with a title and a displayed paragraph, and I import this component into my page. Now I'm going to use IntLayer to declare my content. So I go to my component, and I use the VS Code extension to create a new content declaration file. I add a title and a paragraph. Note that these content declaration files can be present almost anywhere in your code base, and can be declared in different formats, JSON, JavaScript, TSX, etc. As long as they have the .content.x extension. IntLayer will take care of listing all these declaration files and compiling the associated dictionaries. We can then find the content of my component right here. It also generates the types of our dictionaries. IntLayer will observe changes in the content files to automatically update the dictionaries. Now I go into my .gitignore file to exclude anything generated by IntLayer. Next, in my tsconfig.json file, I add the types generated by IntLayer. Once this is done, we are able to call our content in our components via the useIntLayer hook imported from NextIntLayer. I give it a key here, myComponent, which is auto-suggested. I can now insert my content via myContent.title or myContent.paragraph. Again, the content is auto-suggested. If I look at my application, I do have my new title and my paragraph appearing. That's all great, but you're going to tell me that we don't really need IntLayer for that. In fact, the strength of IntLayer is that we'll be able to declare multilingual content through the T function for translation and declare our content in English and in French. Now, if we look at our application, in English, we have our content in English, in Spanish, our title in Spanish, and in French, our title in French. I'll also translate the paragraph. And now, we have our paragraph translated into each language. Here we have an example of a relatively simple content declaration file. But IntLayer provides a whole set of functions, allowing, for example, to import multilingual markdown, interpret markdown, retrieve data from an API, etc. If these are things that interest you, I invite you to watch another video I made where I focus on all of these functions. Another strength of IntLayer is that, compared to other i18n solutions, we have our component and its content file right next to it. If we delete the component, we delete its content file without polluting a large global JSON file. In addition, all translations are centralized in a single file, which allows errors to be generated if a translation is missing. This is configurable. You can also press Tab to generate a translation automatically, which greatly simplifies the process. If we compare to other alternatives like i18 Next, we often find ourselves with one dictionary per language. And to change the data structure, we must replicate the modification in each dictionary. Here with IntLayer, we have the assurance that the content is the same in each language. In addition, IntLayer provides a visual editor and a CMS to interact with the content of our code base, or even outsource this content via the CMS. Now let's see how to call our content in a server component. So I transform my component into a server component, and I get an error, because we cannot use a hook here. I then replace the import with next IntLayer slash server. My component is rendered in all languages again. If we look at the type of title or paragraph, it's not a string, but an IntLayer node. This is related to the visual editor. This can be a problem in some cases, for example, for an area label, which expects a string. To solve this, we use .value to get a string. Finally, know that we can also declare our content files in .tsx and include React Node. It works the same. Be careful, however, not to have duplicate tags, like a paragraph inside another paragraph. I mentioned earlier the possibility of generating internationalized metadata. To do this, I export a generate metadata function, get the locale, and use getIntLayer to get the declared content. We see that the metadata, like the page title, is properly translated. Using this same principle, we can make the sitemap or robots.txt multilingual. I invite you to read the documentation on this topic. The next step is to add buttons to allow the user to change languages. There's an example in the documentation with locale switcher that I will import into my code. I simplify this component a little and import it into my page. If I look at my application, I do have links to change the URL. Final recommendation from IntLayer, also internationalize internal links. For external links, no changes are needed. But for internal links, like slash about, if the user is in French, they would first be directed to about, then redirected by the middleware to slash fr about. For SEO, we'd prefer to directly link to the correct URL. So I hope this video was useful to you. If so, you know what to do. Like, leave a comment on the solution, and if you like what IntLayer offers, consider giving them a star on GitHub. Don't hesitate to report bugs or feature ideas via the issues on GitHub.